big fan of results, and it's nice, all of us like to know what we're working towards. We like to know exactly what it is we are doing. And so we live in our heads, and we live with only 10% of the good news. We live with only 10% of the world, because most of what it means to be human comes from our hearts. When we talk about our common humanity, when we talk about living together, when we talk about the image of God in each human being, we are talking about something in the heart. When we talk about the things that are important to being a Christian, faith, hope, love, those are things of the heart. Those are not things that involve having the correct thoughts. We are bound together as a community of Christ, as a church, and with Christians around the world, not by having the exact same thoughts. In fact, there's a survey sitting out in the narthex asking us to say what it is that we think about faith, to answer some questions, and I hope you all will fill out that survey so that we can understand that we are bound together by our thoughts. We are a very diverse group of people here. I guarantee if there are 100 people in this sanctuary this morning, there are 125 different thoughts on any given subject. We are bound together in our hearts. We are bound together through the love of Jesus Christ. We are bound together because we accepted Jesus Christ, not into our heads, not into our thoughts, but into our hearts. Now, don't get me wrong. You'll never hear me say that thinking is unimportant, that having thoughts is unimportant. God did give us a brain for a reason. But the most important aspects of faith have to do with the heart. That's what the Samaritan in this morning's story got. It's not about just doing exactly what Jesus told them to do. I would like to think that the other 900 did go on, show themselves to the priests, and they were cleansed. Following Jesus Christ doesn't mean being cleansed of the one thing we think we need. It means opening our hearts and being made well. Being made whole. Being healed of all of our brokenness, not just a little bit. If we are following Jesus Christ with our minds, then all we will ever get out of him is the thing that we think we need. That's what the nine lepers got. They got what they thought they needed. But the one leper opened his heart, and he said, "I know there's more, but I don't know what it is, so I will return to the man who could cleanse me of my leprosy and allow him to heal me of all that ails me." We are called as followers of Christ not just to live in our heads, but to open our hearts, to live love for the whole world. Amen. If you have not yet opened your heart up to the love of God, I'd like to invite you forward this morning to invite Jesus into your heart, to make a profession of faith. If there's anyone who would like to join their heart together with this body of Christ, we invite you to come forward, as well as if there is anyone who would like to rededicate, to open up their hearts once again to Jesus Christ. We invite you to come forward as we stand and sing our invitation hymn, number 503, O Christ.
Thank you.
We ask that you bless this food as we sit down together in fellowship. Help us to share with one another your love and to share with those who are outside our walls your love. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.